G'day gamers, I'm Routine Water, and welcome to 7 Days to Die, Dead is Dead, Day 3. Overnight I had to juggle my clothing a little in order to find a suitable outfit for this temperature. I also spent a few skill points. I bought the Camel skill, which will lower my thirst. I also bought the Quality Joe skill, which works with the Scavenging skill to increase the quality of items found. I also spent some time increasing my weapon smithing skill, so the weapons we have now are at roughly level 150. The goals for today are to work towards better weapons, probably by starting a forge, as well as the usual goals of hunting and looting. So let's get started. Here we are, guys. We're on day 3 now. It's almost dawn, so we'll be heading out soon on some adventures. Before we go, I'll just top up my food and water levels. So my food is down at 69 and my water at 64. So I'll eat a few of these charred meat steaks. Okay, our food and water is good. I've got some warmer clothing in case we get cold while we're out. A little bit of emergency food with the snowberries here. So with the sound of dawn, we'll go out and hit the streets. There's a nurse down there, I'll just get rid of her. I don't like to leave zombies hanging around too close to my base while I'm gone, just in case they decide to start breaking down the walls for some reason. Alright, and I will start with this house first. I'll try to search the town using some kind of order, going a block at a time, searching every building. If I come across any animals, I'll stop to hunt those down, because they're one of the items that we particularly need at the moment, is the meat and the hides from the animals. It shouldn't be too hard to find clay. I can leave that until later in the day. Just check behind me to make sure nothing's coming up behind. That was a bad shot. I'll collect stones as I go, as long as it doesn't take up too much time. Saves me having to break apart boulders later. Some painkillers, that's good. Can of chili. Oh, she actually had some good stuff on her. Don't need the ham sandwich, or sham sandwich, sorry. Just have a quick look around, make sure no one's sneaking up on me again. Let's go and check this house out. I don't think I've examined this house. I always check around these steel panels that are on the floor, because they sometimes hide a cavity underneath which has a container in there. Those ones don't, but we'll keep looking. It's another cooking pot. I don't need more than one cooking pot, but they can be broken down for more scrap iron. I'll take this candle. Let's break apart this leather lounge for some free leather and wood, and this will give us some cloth and wood. some more leather. Here you see one of the false panels. You can see there's a gap between the panel and the floor. And if you look closely in that gap, just the right angle, you'll be able to see this backpack or a container in there. So we can search it without actually breaking the panel open. Nothing great in there, but sometimes you find good loot in there. And our first pistol. I was just about to say, I always check the toilets because it's a common place for pistols to be hidden for some reason. It's not a bad quality. That's the advantage of increasing your scavenging and your quality Joe skills. You get better quality items early on. So let's keep moving. See what else we can find in this house. My goal was to find some better weapons today, so I've already got a pistol, which is a good start. Ideally, I would like to have the schematic for the pistol so I can repair and upgrade it. But having a half-decent pistol like this is at least good for emergencies. If I start to get overwhelmed, I can always break the pistol out in order to stay alive. That's about all we're going to find in this house, so we'll leave now and keep searching. I'll just have a quick look around the house. Sometimes there's bags or other containers on the ground. I do sometimes find schematics in these trash cans, so I always search them. We've got a few containers in there. There's a corpse in there, so that might hide something decent. There's some weapon parts. Nothing of very good quality, though. But those magnum parts can be sold for a decent price to the trader. The zombie is nicely provided an opening in the fence for us there. Fortunately, I just heard a gas canister explode. So that's one gas canister I won't be able to retrieve. And I really should go in here and grab this one before it explodes. If they get hit by zombies, they'll explode immediately. Which of course kills the zombie. But it also means you're not able to collect that gas barrel. I'll let this zombie break the door open. It saves me doing it. I'm not going to bother breaking apart those tires on the ground yet, because I won't be building any kind of vehicle for a while. Some ammunition, that's a good find. Get some more leather. When I was saying that you need animal hides to make the bellows for a forge, you can actually replace the animal hide with leather. So if I have trouble finding enough animal hides, well then I should have enough leather anyway. I'll make some duct tape out of this glue just to get it out of my inventory. Duct tape always comes in handy. I think I need some of those short iron pipes for crafting the forge as well, unless the recipe's changed. Well, this is something I forgot about actually. I do need some bandages. You should always carry at least one bandage around with you. My inventory is already getting full, so I'll do a quick drop-off after I leave here before resuming my looting. Alright, here we have one of these containers that need to be broken open. You can see the symbol on the side, and when you go up near it, it doesn't give you the option to open it. So in this case, you hit it until it breaks apart. And then it reveals the searchable crate underneath it. Oh, and there's a nail gun. That is a good find. So, what do I get rid of? I'll just scrap that, get some paper, and take the nail gun. Electrical parts. Alright, this inventory is already becoming an issue. I might as well scrap the plant fiber hood so I can make another one easily anyway. And this situation is ideal for having this container on the wall of the base here, rather than having to go all the way inside to drop things off. It's much quicker just doing it like this. I'll leave the snowberries, I'm sure I'm not going to need those anytime soon. Now, I haven't seen these before. I'll have to check that out. That is interesting. This guy tried to sneak up on me. I wonder if that's a new type of bunker in those wells. I'm just searching around these logs because on some other buildings the logs sometimes hide some lootable items, but not in this case. So this is one of the buildings I hadn't seen before. So I'll spend a little bit of extra time just looking around so I don't miss anything. I'm not sure if there would be anything hidden under the rug here. Yeah, it's probably not worth digging up to find. Starting to get a little bit hot. I'll just take my gloves off. And you can see that door was reinforced as though someone was trying desperately to survive in there. Come on, poke your head up again. won't waste my time with that. There is probably still some gas barrels in there that I would like to get. So, let's go and collect these quickly before he explodes anymore. Now, try taking these guys out. Not going to take a chance hitting him with the melee any more than that. Came close to dying too many times in the last episode. Hello. That's pretty clever. I might as well search this gas station now I'm here. I'll just put these frames up just to slow down any zombies who might try to sneak up on me. Sort of shotgun schematic. Well, that'll allow me to craft the sort of shotgun if I can find all the parts. As well as making repairs and upgrades to that type of weapon. The only unfortunate thing is the sort of shotgun is one of the worst weapons in the game. Unless it's been dramatically improved since the updates. Now it may be worth repairing this one. You see, the one I just crafted from you is only level 20. And this one's level 200 because it's one that I found. Now, if I repair it, it will reduce the level of it because my level is so low in tool crafting. But we'll have a look, and it may, well, you can see it's still much higher than the level of the axes I can craft from scratch. So it's definitely worth repairing at this stage. You can see this room has another one of these crates that need to be broken open. There's an auger blade and an anvil for the anvil is put into the forge. Actually, I'll take that water to that I can boil. And there's a first aid bandage. The difference between the first aid bandage and the regular bandage is the first aid bandage not only stops bleeding, it also gives you a little bit of a health boost. And here is two wrenches in one sink. That is a very good find. The wrenches allow you to break apart mechanical items to get resources from them. And it can also be used to upgrade items. And it's a part of the recipe for certain things like workbenches and cement mixers. So finding two of those in fairly good quality is a very good find. There's a flashlight, it's a good find, and some chicken soup. Just have a quick look out here. Alright, I'll head back to the base and do a quick drop-off. Well, that's a bunker just there. That small shack with the fence behind it. If you go inside that building, you'll find some steel panels or some panels on the floor that you can break apart. And there'll be stairs leading down to a bunker. which is a very good spot early in the game. Well, it's locked. Let's break this open. I wonder if this leads to the bunker. That would be interesting. There is spikes down the bottom of that. So I'm going to have to be careful here. I'm not sure if there is a way to get down there without hurting yourself on those spikes. Could probably put I may be able to drop down onto those frames. Yeah. Let's see if I can break these apart. These have blood on them as though zombies have been down here before. There's a strong steel door there as well. It's locked. Oh, 8,000. That will take much more time than I can spare. Okay. Just want to get this out of the way so I don't start bleeding. That's something I didn't want. There we go. Now, hopefully, I can get up here. Ah, oh, there is a missing section of the ladder there. So I'll just craft a wooden ladder section to replace it. I can't type. Wooden ladder. Let's craft one section just so I can get back out. Alright, well that's pretty interesting. I'll leave that frame on top of there just so I don't know why really. I was going to say to stop zombies going down there, but I'm not sure why zombies would go down there if there's no people there. I do have a feeling that that might... Well, I was going to say it might go to the bunker, but the bunker is all the way over there. I think it just goes to an underground bunker in this field here. Which is still interesting. Once I have some better tools to break that door open, I will definitely go and check that out. But for now, we'll keep searching these buildings where we can. I always close these doors even though the doors aren't going to stop a zombie. At least you'll hear them breaking in. And here is another backpack hidden under a steel panel. Some gun parts. And another gun in the toilet. More interested in the ammunition than the pistol. Because it's such low quality. That gun will actually have 15 bullets already loaded in it, but I won't be able to access them until I have read the handgun assembly schematic. So I will try to keep that gun until I have the schematic so that I can get those bullets out before I get rid of those. Before I get rid of the parts from it. Let's keep moving. I don't want to spend too much time here. It's starting to get a little bit late. I think after I've searched a couple more buildings, I'll start completing the other tasks I talked about, such as gathering clay and stone to make the forge. This is already open. makes for quick entry. This was another new building for Alpha 15, I believe. Mega Crush. Some kind of energy drink. Oh, I searched the coolers for water and beer. Can never have too much of either of those. I like to take my time in these buildings that I haven't been in very often before, just so that I don't miss anything. There is a safe there, but they take a long time to break apart, so I'll leave that till later. And another pistol. I'm having a lot of luck with the toilets today. Like I said before, always search the toilet. Some people are a bit squeamish about it for some reason. But hey, this is survival, as I've said before. So why not stick your hand down the toilet? And there's another wrench. Again, it was under a sink. That's a low quality one, but it'll be fine for using in a recipe. I'm not going to bother about these breaking apart the couches. I might start heading back, but I will go into this diner on the way back. As I usually do, I'll check around the perimeter first. Starting to get a little bit hot. Ah, this is a good find, a mining helmet. That provides a light for nighttime. And a claw hammer. It's another good tool. It's very good for building and upgrading. My inventory might be getting a little bit too full to bother actually going into the diner. So I might do a quick drop off. I'll kill these guys. And then I'll do a quick drop-off and come back. Actually, I don't think I'll have time to come back. I'll probably have to work on the forge next. Here's the bank. If you're stuck in a town and you need to build a shelter for a night, building one on top of the banks is on top of a bank is quite a good idea because the structures are so solid. And even if the zombies detect you and spend a night trying to break the building down, they're unlikely to succeed before daybreak. So if I go to a big city or something and there's a lot of zombies around, I sometimes camp on top of banks. This is the little shack where you can see those steel panels on the floor. If you break those open, there's stairs down to a bunker, which can be easily secured. The only downside to that is that, well, obviously you can end up being trapped because there's only one entrance and one exit. It's easy to defend, but it also... Mushroom seeds. I haven't seen those before. Mushroom spores, sorry. It's easy to defend, but it's also easy to end up being trapped. Here's a backpack. Backpacks usually hold good items. I just need to make room for it somehow. I'll just scrap the gloves. I can make more gloves easily. These brown areas on the map, I believe, are clay. D- dig up the clay, I'm going to need a stone shovel. I'll only need one of those because I don't need very much clay, but I'll make a couple more axes, because stone axes, because I'll need a fair bit of stone. Alright, so this is as good as anything. Might as well collect some iron while I'm getting stone. All I have to do is make sure nothing's sneaking up behind me. Alright, we should have plenty of stone for now, so let's collect some clay. This looks like clay here. Yeah, you can see the clay collecting in the bottom right corner. Alright, let's head back to the base. And look at that, a pistol book. That's exactly what I needed. This will allow me to repair the pistols and upgrade them with better parts as I find them, as well as get the ammunition from low-quality pistols. So now I know the pistol recipe. I'm in good shape. So it was definitely worth searching that car. Okay, that's everything from my external chest, so I can lock up the doors now, lock up the entrances, just in case something does try to get in. And now I can start sorting through my inventory. I guess we'll begin with the weapons. I'll take these complete pistols. These ones are too low quality to be of any use to me, especially when I have one that's much better. So you can see the individual parts for the pistol, what level they are. And none of the parts in these pistols are better than any of the parts in the pistol I'm keeping. So to get the ammunition out of these pistols, you can see that it's loaded with 15. If you just click on assemble, it will take the 15 pistols out and put them in your the 15 rounds out and put them in your inventory. Now these two pistols, even though they're such low quality, they're worth quite a bit at the trader, so I'll definitely be selling those. And I'll be keeping the 9mm ammo for my good pistol. And this flashlight I'm going to attach to my pistol straight away. And to do that, you just select the pistol, click on assemble, and there is a slot for each weapon part, so each part is interchangeable. So I'll just drag the flashlight onto the flashlight slot, click on close, and now my pistol has the flashlight attached. Anytime you assemble the pistol, though, you have to remember to select it and click R to reload it, because it will empty the ammunition from the pistol when you assemble it. And if I press F now, you can see that I've got a flashlight on my pistol. Press F again to turn it off. So a forge requires 50 stone. We have plenty of that. 50 lumps of clay, I have that in storage. One short iron pipe, I have that. And a bellows. So we need to make a bellows. And that can be made either with 20 animal hide or 20 leather, as well as wood and one short iron pipe. And the first thing I will craft is the bellows. Need one of those. So we have our bellows. And now we'll craft the forge. Okay, so there's our forge. Now, where shall I put it? I think I can put it up there. Hopefully it doesn't collapse when I try this. Nope, oh, that's alright. Defy gravity, but that's okay. And we'll put our anvil into the tool section, just like we did in the campfire. I won't go into details about how the forge works in this episode. But basically, you need to put raw material, smelt raw materials, into the forge's bank, which is here. And then from the items that are in, from the materials that are in the bank, you can forge other items out of that. Alright, so I will leave this video here. We accomplished a fair bit today. We did a lot of looting. We've got the forge going. We've got some raw materials. We also found some tools and a few pistols, so we're in pretty good shape once again. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on day 4.